Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Hopefully you can see me in the stream. Oh, I believe you can. Yeah, you can. Good morning. Who's here? Oh, my eyes are terrible this morning. I'm so sorry. I'm still waking up. I've literally been up 10 minutes, so... Listen. I know the lighting's bad. I know it is. Everybody ready? 6:30, look at that. Actually on time. It's your boy. Good morning, John. Get rid of that mouse. Here we go. Right. Another week has started. So yeah, I'm going to sort my lighting out this week, try and get something a little bit better, because I've said it before, I just filmed a video. Did you watch my Q&A? Hopefully you watched my Q&A. The lighting in here is terrible. I've got like 4 down lights, so all you get is shadows. But that's alright. Hopefully you understand. Hopefully you don't really need to see my face. So today's workout is fat dad's fast legs, 7-minute warm up, 3 1-minute at 300 watts, 4 efforts at 10 seconds for 700 watts. I don't know if I'm being stupid by putting them in, I really don't, but I need to do something, so yeah, just thought I'd mix it up from last week's. And what I realise is I genuinely do need to train. Did you watch the race on Thursday night? Oh my god. So many schoolboy errors made there. So many schoolboy errors made. 1, I didn't warm up. 2, I tried to stay with... Cheers, Justin. Thanks for the rhino. Thanks for the comment. I tried to stay with the A group. B, 3, my Zwift lagged out, and I got dropped from the group that I was in. And then I saw a group coming, so I thought, I'll tag onto the back of them. Here we go. Start speeding up. And they were all riding at like 8 watts a kilo. I'm like, what's happening here? Then I realised that it was the A group sprinting for the finish. And I still had another lap to do. So forgive me if I'm wrong here, but am I right in thinking that next Monday is Christmas Day? I thought it was Christmas Eve. Alright. I love you. I love Zwift. I love streaming. But I'm lonely enough to get up on Christmas morning and do it because I don't want to spoil my Christmas day. I want to be lazy and hang out with the family. So maybe we'll do a Friday workout as well this week. Or maybe... Justin, I've not suffered like that for ages. And it doesn't help when you don't have a warm-up. So yeah, maybe I'll do a Friday workout this week instead of Monday next week. Or do one later in the week, I don't know. But as long as you hit that notification button and you're subscribing, then you'll be good. You'll know when it's coming. I'm just finishing my coffee off. before we start. I had a terrible night's sleep last night. Did not get to sleep. Must have only had like 6 hours, which for me isn't much. It's meant the biggest problem with that is you've got A's, B's and C's and D's. You've got everybody in one massive group, which means you get, if you've warmed up and you can suffer for just a little while longer than everyone else for the first 10 minutes, you've got a good chance of being in a good group and getting them to pull you along. But I always find myself in no man's land, like right on the front of the group that's splitting, and I just haven't got enough energy to get across, so a bit annoying. But I'm not fit. I'm in no way, shape or form anywhere near where I should be in terms of fitness, so, and I'm nowhere near where I should be in terms of warming up for this workout. So we've got 2 minutes to go, and then it's going to be straight into my first interval of 1 minute at 300 watts. That sounds like a lot, I think, but it should be a good workout. I don't know if I have overfaced myself with this one, I really don't. Get back. Look at them doing their own workout. A proper Zwift workout. Who needs that? Get involved in the fat dad. There's a good chance, John, that I'm going to be training New Year's Day. I'm not that fussed about New Year's Eve and all that jazz, so I think I'm going to be, I think I'll train through that. Right, get myself ready. Let me know in the comments below, how is the... it could be coming back up, that. I really don't know. It's normally not too bad. But again, these intervals I've set myself, I could be... I might knock the wattage down a little bit on them if I feel like they're too hard, so... Especially this early in the morning. But I wanted to mix it up. Much shorter intervals rather than the longer ones from last week. So also make sure you keep an eye out for that second part of the Q&A coming out. I just answered every single question, so first effort, here we go. I'm going to hold there for the first effort, that's enough. Get my legs awake. 20 seconds gone. Anybody see Cycling Cam's race yesterday? Was it yesterday or day before? That kid is fit. Sat there at like 400 watts, not even panting. John, I'm going to answer that in a second. Okay. 2 minutes rest. That's a godsend, that 2 minutes. 100 watts. Alright. I felt it. It was hard. If you go on YouTube and search the BMW electric scooter, I was in the promo video of that, and that was an electric scooter. That was cool. That's the only e-motorbike I've ridden, or zero motorbike, which is technically a scooter. But the speed of acceleration, the silence, apart from the whirring, they're pretty cool. I would like to ride a zero bike, but you'll never replace that sound. No, those nerves you get when you fire up a motorbike. When you fire up a motorbike and you know you're going on track, and it's just like bubbling away, like it's saying, I'm gonna fuck you up. I'm gonna screw your life up, Mother Hubbard. So get ready. And I love that. Okay, one effort done. Next effort coming up in 10 seconds. Feel free to leave any questions below if you're in the session, which I don't think you are. I think it's just me on my own today. That's cool. Here we go. And also for prizes for guessing what I'm listening to again this morning. Thank you for the ride on. Ah, this isn't too bad. This is not too bad. Might be a little bit different later on down the line. But I don't think I'm overreaching here. Nice. If you're doing this training session on plus one or on demand, I apologise for the chatting now. I'm relaxed, good. 100 watts. Hopefully you're sticking to your wattage, whatever it is, getting the workout. In terms of effort, we're about a level 7. An 8, maybe an 8 out of 10 there. We've got one more here before we go into the short sprints. This is good, I'm enjoying it. Give me a shout, let me know what everyone's up to today. What you've been up to yesterday. So by how smooth your power is. Yeah, I am using nerd mode, yeah. I've got it on like the average of, is it 3 seconds or something like that? For the power. There's no way I could be this consistent at 6:30 in the morning. Which I guess is enough. I don't know. I'd like to try it without erg mode. I can stay pretty consistent. Once I've worked out for what gear I'm in, how fast I need to be going, I can pretty much keep a cadence relatively good. That's one thing about being a good track rider or spending so much time on the track. You get a decent pedaling technique from it, so. Oh my God, John, get to sleep. Read a book, go and read a book. Don't watch this. Well, wait, watch this till the end and then go and read a book. Next effort, third and final effort of these first three. Let's get it just above 300, there we go. I think I got in bed last night at 11 and I was up till 12:30 last night. I thought I was going to struggle to get up this morning, but as soon as my alarm went off, boom, I was up. Felt good, felt fresh. I am getting a few dips of a loss of power, which is strange. Workout crew! Alright, this one's biting just a little bit. Worked about an 8 out of 10 now. Oh yeah. This feels good. And another thing, feel free to leave your comments about what workouts we should be doing on here. If this ever becomes a thing and there's more than just me training, I want to have a variety of workouts that we can do. But I want to make them kind of not too intense, but I certainly want to get a workout out. But I want someone who has very little experience on Zwift or very little fitness to be able to join in on these. Should just get my cadence above 85 or so. Justin, the chances are there's not going to be a velodrome near you. But me personally, one of my favourite workouts that improved my cadence speed was had a set of rollers, had a fixed gear track bike. So you just need a fixed gear so you can teach your body to go through a full pedal stroke. Really light gear, so if you're on a road bike, you'd be in your easiest climbing gear. And you do 10 seconds flat out sprint. They'll teach you cadence speed, and it'll also teach you how to control the bike on the rollers, which is pretty difficult when you start getting the speed up. 700 watts, here we go. I need more gear. I need more gear, there you go. I'm gonna fail on this one, aren't I? I'm gonna fail on that. That's in a probably Virgo mode. It doesn't kick in quite when you need it to when you're doing sprints. So yeah, you do. And it's not really training. It's not training the muscle. It's because you're going so fast on such a light gear, you're training the nervous system to learn the ability to go fast. So you do full 20 minute warm up, 10 seconds on, 2 minutes off, 10 seconds on, 2 minutes off. Five of those, rest for 5 minutes, and then repeat it. I think that was one of my favorite workouts. That was one of my go-to workouts when I needed to increase my pedaling technique and my pedaling speed. Here we go, let's go again. Give me more power. There you go. And the other piece of advice I'd give you for that one as well is if you go to the gym, if you're training in the gym, do it after a gym session. If you've been in the gym, lifted heavy weights, you've opened up those neurological pathways, which allow those legs to go a little bit faster, and it ingrains deeper into it, so you can get that speed. If you can get that cadence up to around 225-ish, I can guarantee that your new comfort zone would be up around 80. Come on, give me more power, kick in. There we go. Okay, one more of those. You've had a robot for less than 2 weeks, wow. mountain biking. All right, so you're not a complete newbie. But yeah, it's not a cadence sport really, mountain bike, is it? But that said, your mountain bike with those really, really, really short gears will be great on the rollers. Spin your legs up. Yeah, you're right, John. You're right. But it's the same with any fitness goal. Any goal you're trying to achieve, you've got to go above and beyond what you're trying to achieve to then make what it is you're trying to achieve the norm. Do you know what I mean? Alright, they're biting now. They're biting. Have I got one more? I might be onto my three sets of 1 minute at 300 watts now. I think I am. That was 404, yeah. Well, John and Justin, glad you're part of the road community now. I swear, track riding on a fixed gear, even on an outdoor velodrome, is so beneficial to increasing cadence, increasing your pedal technique to actually get what you need out of the pedal stroke. Because I can guarantee, and this is just a guess, from a mountain biker's point of view, there's a lot of stomping on the pedals. Down, down, down. It's not necessarily smooth pedaling action. Okay, we're on to the last set of intervals now. Three efforts, 300 watts for 60 seconds. 3.4 watts a kilo here. This will do. This is enough. This is more than enough. Especially after those little sprints. Let's get some music back on. Stay strong, Pridge. That's it. Just above 300. Come on. 130. Ah. Oh. Yeah, heart rate's getting up there. Just where I want it to be. To then come down. Force it to come down as quick as I can. I've got 2 minutes rest between these bad boys. Get a proper recovery in here. Let's throw a few ride-ons out there for other people. Here we go. Give you one. Kev, you, it's just got one. You're going to see it. Ping! 40 seconds. John, get on it. Oh. Yeah, John, there's not many velodromes in the US. At least not velodromes that are well known. You've got the LA Velodrome. There's a great outdoor velodrome in where is it now? Is it Pennsylvania? No. Where is it? It's just outside New York. I wish I put my fan on. Yeah, we're pretty lucky here. We've got Glasgow, we've got Manchester, we've got London, we've got Newport, and we've got Derby. So we've got five world-class indoor velodromes. The furthest one from me is 4 hours away. So within 4 hours I've got five velodromes to pick from, which is crazy in this small country. But could be one of the reasons. Oh, I'm struggling now. One more, here we go. Which might be why we produce so many good track cyclists. Throwing out some more ride-ons. That's Kit. That's good. Oh. Okay, 1 minute and then we've got the last interval coming up. Shit. I could not imagine living in the US. When my country sits in like a third of a state. Unless I was in one of the massive cities, I'd feel like I was in the middle of nowhere, I guess. 30 seconds last effort. Thanks for sticking by, guys, by the way. Hopefully, John, you're going to feel a bit more tired after this. Into the house. Hey guys. Let's go. Last effort, 300 watts. Just make sure it's above 300 all the way. There we go. Hold that. Hold tight. Ah, up the bridge. There you go. This erg mode is. I just need it just to grip just a little more. Stop it, above 300. The faster I go, the easier it becomes, and it's hard to maintain 300. Last effort, 10 seconds, here we go. 4 minute cooldown coming up after this. There we go. Workout is done. Cheers, Paul. What kind of a name's that? There's someone on Zwift. Champion Ironman. What's his full name? Modest. Let's give him a ride on. Oh, my butt is hurting. Ow. 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 So hopefully, if we can get enough of a buzz around these workouts, we'll try and go to Zwift and ask them if they'll put them in as a bit of a starters workout, a fun workout to get people involved. There's a lot of serious working out there to be done. I understand that. There's a lot of serious cyclists. But some people just want to have a little bit of fun, have a little bit of a workout, and push themselves to their own ability without feeling they're in a bunch of a pack full of professional riders. And clearly, as you can see, I ain't no professional rider. Okay, so 10 seconds and then we're down to 100 watts, I believe, for the cool down. Perfect. Oh, what? 140. Get that heart rate down now. Once my heart rate's down below 130, around 120, I feel I'm recovered then. And my aim is always to try and get it down there as quick as possible after a session or after an effort. The quicker you can get it down, the quicker you can recover. More chance you've got of being able to go again for the next effort whenever it comes. Adrian Timmins, let's give him a quick ride on. The legend. If you don't follow him, make sure you follow him on Zwift. Give him a ride on. Quality coach. Quality rider back in the day as well. Cheers, Clarkie. Appreciate that. And we've nearly got 5 gold stars. What a way to start a Monday. So if you want to use this workout, feel free to search for it in the Zwift workouts. I think you can do that. I think that's a thing. Maybe if you go on my, I don't know how you do it, but if you go on my name maybe, you'll be able to do it yourself. Obviously you'll be able to alter your own FTP to suit it. The timing's going to stay the same, the workout's going to stay the same, but obviously your wattage will change so you can get the workout you need for your ability and your current fitness level. Oh, this music has been terrible this morning. Pardon me. Give Mick a ride on. There you go, Mick, enjoy that. Tim Bacon Searle always gets a ride on. Oh, look at that, I get one in return. 1:45 and then we are done. Thank you for sticking by. Make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and that notification button. More and more streams coming up. I think we're racing Thursday, but again, hit that notification button. You should get notification when I put the event live, and then obviously you get notification when the event starts, I hope. And you can come and watch me suffer again. If I can, I'm going to get into a B race, a B group only race next week, so, or this week, so I don't overreach myself and I can try and get a, like, stay with the front people. I don't really care for winning a race. I understand that Zwift races aren't real life races, but it'd be good to be able to kind of ride with people that are working just as hard. Down to 80 watts, heart rate 115, 40 seconds to go. Nice. I feel like I've had a workout, I don't feel like I pushed too hard. Kind of awake now, ready to smash my day. That was good. I'm quite proud of myself for that workout. Didn't go stupid, but got enough out of it. Am I gonna get 5 stars though? Here we go, let's take it to the finish. Oh, finish on 60 watts. Bum 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 bum. Let's bring that up. Okay, only 163 average, 17k, half an hour's work, 1.1 slice a piece of 35 TSS. I don't know if 35 is a strong number, a big number. So you can see heart rate's up here. You can see how it just spikes, drops, spikes, drops, spikes, drops, spikes, 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 spikes. Let's have a look at that cadence. Stays relatively smooth all the way through. Bit of an increase towards this one here at the end. And then you can just see it drop off there. Same with this one, you get a little fast spike. It catches up with itself and then stays smooth. But here, nice and smooth all the way through. You can see I just hit a little bit of zone 5 as well, but the majority of the workout, zone 3 and zone 4, exactly where I wanted to be. Oh, that's a nice view. So there we go, that's the workout done. I'd like to maintain that that view from for a whole workout. If you feel like you need to do more of a cool down, if you don't feel like that's another workout, feel free to carry on if you are watching this on demand or plus one. Otherwise, thanks for watching. Keep an eye out on the channel for the next stream, but I think we're going to be streaming on Thursday. Ciao for now.